he's not going to be down stage with me. I'm going
to. I've seen two
heads. You're going to walk up stage, and you're going to go, oh, see it?
Yeah.
I can't believe this. You're absolutely right, and this is absolutely wonderful.
Okay.
This is the first time that I've directed this show, and I like the troubling aspect of it, which is, of course, you know, Kate's big speech at the end, and how can she possibly do that? And is this about men ruling women and women losing their identity and stuff? Because I find it the absolute opposite.
She is your treasure.
She is your treasure.
She must have a husband. Now I see she is your treasure. See, so it's that discovery right now that you really, you know, and so remember what you're doing. You're trying to hurt him as well.
Yeah.
You know, it's not all about being a victim, but it's about lashing out and trying to hurt back.
Yeah.
You know.
Okay.
And that I like the will you not suffer me being at kind of, you know, hello, Dad. And then change. Nay, now I see. She is your treasure. She must have a husband.
The play, The Taming of the Shrew, is a parable. And instead of it being a battle of the sexes, the misconception that Petruchio tames Kate, it's more that he actually allows her to be herself. Because everybody becomes somebody else in this play. Everybody. Sly becomes somebody else. The Lord at the beginning becomes somebody else in order to get what they want or to play the joke on.
How mean you that? No mates for you unless you were of gentler, kinder mold.
Faith, sir, you shall never need to fear. I wis it is not halfway to her heart, but if it were, doubt not her care should be to comb your noddle with a three-legged stool and paint your face and use you like a fool!
Good Lord, deliver us from all such devils!
Me too, good Lord.
She has kind of become the shrew for the most part, for her father's attention or just for anybody to pay attention to her at all. Nay, now I see. She is your treasure. She must have a husband. I must dance barefoot on her wedding day! Some attention, whether it's negative or positive, and so, like a lot of people in the play, she has kind of adopted this persona just to be somebody. It's probably forgotten along the way who she was before, maybe, you know, and how to be not a shrew. She's just kind of caught in a cycle of her own frustration and anger that just feeds into it. Petruchio is unlike any of the other men in her life, any of the other men who are around her, be it her father or her sister's suitors, he is just different and kind of throws her for a loop. It's really important to me and to Tony Pike, who plays Petruchio, and to Barrett Cooper, who directs the play, that Kate and Petruchio really be a team and a partnership by the end of the play, that we see that they have really reached a point of great respect and affection and love for each other that lets them play and have fun and even mock the conventions around them and the people around them who are still kind of stuck in their roles, that they can be themselves with each other.
I love working with Kelly. She's a charm. She's always down to try anything, down to do anything, down to go for it once, go for it twice, mm-hmm. See what happens. Kelly's a trooper, and I think that's very, very appreciated from any actor. You know, I think we've tried to do a lot of work to go away from the typical Kate and Petruchio kind of relationship. I like to think that the characters are very much enamored with one another. Hopefully we can find that within the text and support that within the text, but I think our actions and the way that we play them do come across in that manner.
I am trying to woo Bianca, deter other wooers, and cover his butt while he's pretending to be somebody else. All those things, kind of my job to do.
I'm just his servant.
She does what we tell her to do. Yeah.
And causes some mischief sometimes.
Yeah. Sometimes.
I'm trying to woo Bianca, so I'm posing as a schoolmaster, while he poses me. Yeah.
What is he, Biondello?
Oh, master, a mercatante or a pedant. I know not what, but formal in apparel. Engaging.
Yeah, mercatante or a stop, look at the audience, pedant. Okay, do that. And really do very Italian on mercatante. Okay. Oh, yeah, sure.
You got it. The Tames, Tame Shrew and Charm heard chattering tongue.
Oh, master, I walked so long that I am dog weary, but at last I spied an ancient angel coming down the hill. We'll serve the tournament.
What is he, Biondello?
Oh, master, a mercantante. Or pedant. I know not what, but formal in apparel, and gait in countenance, but surely like a father.
Hey, Smoochie.
And what oven, Trotty-O?
No, it's not me.
Literally, just keep sucking fat. And what oven, Trotty-O? Go back now.
Playing Bianca Manola, who's the sister to Kate the Shrew. She is the younger daughter of Baptista Manola and is not allowed to marry until her older sister Kate does. In the beginning, she's really quite a devil. To her sister and treats her very cruelly. Bianca is very bitter towards Kate for not just doing what she's told so Bianca can, you know, marry if that's what it takes for her to get some sexual interaction. She's still pretty much a devil.
Separate, very talented casts, and getting to enjoy spending time with all these great people.
In the Rover, yes, I am playing a supporting lead. I'm playing Colonel Belleville, who's one of the three or four lovers of the show. And so I have a bigger part in that show. In The Taming of the Shrew, I'm playing several utility roles. I'm one of the players at the beginning, I'm one of the servants in the big dinner scene, and I'm playing the Haberdasher, who has one line, but it's going to be memorable. You've got to keep, you know, both shows separate in your mind as far as your lines and your blocking and also sort of the style, you know, because while there's so many similarities between The Rover and Taming of the Shrew, there's still so many differences. Mm-hmm. So it's definitely, you've got to be able to juggle those mentally. And then especially when production kicks in, especially on the two show days, having to be one person at the matinee and then somebody else completely at night, you know, it's a huge challenge. That's what makes the repertory so exciting, I think, for audience members, but mostly the actors. I mean, it's so cool to get to do these two completely different stories at the same time.
That bit of interrupting.
That's okay.
That's great because it takes all over there.
Yeah.
She is a blabbermouth and she just loves to talk about herself. Make sure you hit the word none. Hit the word none a lot. Are you okay?
Fine. Yeah.
Fine. Use it.
I got
it. Oh, that's good.
All right.
Well, I think that the Rover is a bit of a strange play for a restoration comedy in that it is indeed a restoration comedy in that it was written in the restoration and it's sort of a comedy.
Mm-hmm.
But it's more than that. And I think Afra Ben knew it. And I don't even know whether it was performed with the drama intact, but there's a lot of drama here. It's a lot about something that we can all plug into, which is about the betrayal of a love gone wrong.
Why would you, sir, abuse my lady's faith and use me so inhumanly? Me, a maid so young, so innocent.
Line.
Dost thou not know?
Dost thou not know thy life is in my power?
Or think my lady cannot be revenged?
Now thou art silent. Guilt has struck thee dumb.
I'm playing Angelica Bianca, who is a famous courtesan. She is very confident when it comes to her profession and to her relationships and her friendship with her lady in the game, but also her relationships with men in town. So she's confident, she's very strong, and she's witty.
Mm-hmm.
But when it comes to love, she has a pretty difficult time, so that's interesting to explore. Jeremy's an incredible actor, very giving, very talented, and just kind of on fire. So we have a good time finding new moments in the script, you know, trying out different choices for the characters, and he's perfect, yeah.
I am playing the Rover, Wilmore.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. What makes him tick is the love for women, and love is a very loose term. His real fascination with the female form.
Mm-hmm.
He goes after every woman he meets, and hopefully he can find love in that quest.
See this young spark here.
He'll tell her who I am.
Who do you think this is?
Nay, dear captain, I'm undone if you once discover me.
Nay, she shall see how precious a mistress I have.
Will you be such a devil?
This small ambassador comes not from a person of quality, as you imagine, or he says, but from a very errant gypsy. The talkingest, pratingest, cantingest little devil animal that I ever saw.
Would I were off this place if I ever go captain hunting again.
I am playing Helena in the Rover.
Her goal is to be loved, to find love, so that she doesn't have to spend the rest of her life living in a nunnery, which she really doesn't want to do.
An impertinent thing is a young girl bred in a nunnery. How full of questions. Prithee, no more, Helena. I've told thee more than thou understandest already.
The more's my grief. I would fain know as much as you, which makes me so inquisitive, nor is't enough. I know you're a lover, unless you tell me too who 'tis you sigh for.
When you're a lover, I'll think you fit for a question of that nature.
'Tis true, I never was a lover yet, but I begin to have a shrewd guess what 'tis to be so. And fancy it very pretty to sigh and sing, and blush and wish and dream and wish and long and wish to see the man. Line.
What I do?
And when I do, look pale and tremble, just as you did when our brother brought home the fine English colonel to see you. What do you call him? Don Belleville?
Fie, Helena!
Clorinda is in love, and she would do anything to be with Belleville. So love is what makes her tick.
Madam, you do not know me. Move a little this way.
Belleville!
Shh.
Meet thy voice and take this knowledge in.
Neil and I went to the same academy in New York. And we knew that we were both living in Louisville, but this is my first chance to work with him on stage. And he's hilarious and he's compelling. The story itself is so fascinating, and people, even though it's really out there, people can relate to it on the base level of love and relationships and what that means. And this is the first classical piece that I've ever done. So it's been a challenge for me, and I didn't think I'd be able to find a connection with this kind of language, but it's all there.
Energy, pace, don't let it flag. Don't let anybody escape you, as it were. Don't let anybody in the audience get away from you. And you do that by real connection. Plot over story. What that means, again, is that you're always in the process of pulling people in to the human beings out there. And that leads me into final thing is make sure that you don't gravitate toward cartoon, that the comedy comes out of the character.
I'm very pleased with the actors. It's a real ensemble piece, and that's what makes it different from a lot of other plays of the time. A lot of plays of the time, there would be two or three, maybe four, significantly focal characters. This play has 12 characters.
Tomorrow, or it will be too late. It is not my friendship to Antonio which makes me urge this, but love to thee, and hatred of Vengentia. Therefore, resolve upon tomorrow.
Sir, I shall strive as to become your sister.
I'll both believe and trust you. Adieu. And, make it your business to watch this wild cat.
As becomes his sister?
I stood on it.
I'm trying to figure out if the bum rolls are one size fits all. Because this is my goddamn
hips,
this is not working out.
Wait,
what do you? What do you?
This isn't even the hardest piece of costume to understand. It's just a nightgown.
Figure it out.
Just put it on.
Small triumphs every day.
I'll be honest, it really feels real now because we're on the stage and in costume.
Yeah, that's
Wednesday
right.
Night, I will not have earrings or rings on, I guess. Makeup. Yeah. You're going to do mine?
Sure.
Thanks.
Oh.
It's not going to be very interesting.
I know, but you can help my eyes stand out.
Girl, we're gonna slut it up.
That's so pretty.
Oh my god, is there like not a.
Wow.
There's nothing here.
Whatever this is.